Gospel of Luke, chapter 13. It is a very, very familiar passage of Scripture. And he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath. And behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity 18 years, and was bowed together, could in no wise lift up herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him, said unto her, Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity. And he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight.
Yes, sir.
And glorified God. Here was a woman who was badly crippled. For 18 years she had been bent over. I'm afraid that no doubt she suffered great pain in her body as she walked with difficulty. Housework was unusually a hard burden. And I kind of feel like she even has some difficulty sleeping at night because of her bent back.
Yeah.
It had been so long that she had forgotten what it was like to be comfortable either sitting or lying in bed.
Yes. Yeah.
And you know, 18 years is a long time to be in that kind of condition.
Yeah.
It had become a great mental burden to her. See, not only was her body bent, but according to the text, her spirit had been warped. Luke points out that she had a spirit of infirmity. My brothers and sisters, to be handicapped in the body is one thing. But when a handicap gets into the mind, it can be so much worse. All the time, this woman was conscious of her bent back. In my spiritual mind, I see whenever people looked at her, she felt that they were thinking of her crippled condition. She was painfully aware that she was not pretty or attractive to other people. They had built up in her a sense of inferiority. She would see other women whose bodies were straight and strong and would feel bitterness and resentment in her spirit. The spirit of infirmity, my brothers and sisters, is much harder to overcome than the infirmity itself. Yeah, she was bent over. That means that when she walked around all the time with her eyes facing the ground, looking up was an added effort, and she probably didn't do it often. In fact, all she could see was the dirt and filth of the world. She missed the blue sky, the birds in the air, the rainbows, and the sunsets, unless they were on the horizon. Her bent back obscured her view from the beautiful, inspiring things of life. And I'm sure that she had become a miserable, almost hopeless person because she had lost her vision, her dreams, and her high purpose. Truth is, I've come to know many people with the spirit of infirmity. They let some physical handicap or some emotional setback get into their minds, and it makes them bitter and complaining. And in some cases, they have forsaken everything, allowing that bitterness to fester like an open infected wound. It may have been something done to someone they love, or it may have been a situation that they were in, and they thought it would have turned out one way and it turned out another way. But whatever it was, they lost the incentive for life. And they allow themselves to sink into depression, despair, and cynicism. Their bent back, whether physical, mental, or emotional, becomes a tragedy when they let the infirmity take possession of their spirit instead of developing a spirit that takes possession of the infirmity.
Yeah.
There are a lot of church folk in the church who have a bent back. Yeah, they have allowed their minds to become handicapped. Because instead of believing God, that they have let folk tell them what they can and cannot do in the church. And one of the worst, I feel, handicaps in the church is believing that only certain people can do certain things. And the other side of that, y'all, is just as true. Believing that if you don't do it, it won't get done.
Yes.
I heard a preacher, Debbie, some years ago, a so-called big preacher, say, if Zion needs some money, let them come to me.
Well,
that preacher's no longer with Zion. But because Zion trusts God as a source and not a resource, we are entering this new quadrennial with a restructured church that can operate more efficiently with less money. Now, let me say this for this woman of the text. She did do something to help herself. See, many people under the weight of some infirmity just give up. They give up and just quit. But this woman kept on going. And for her, that's really good. One thing she did was go to church. Every now and then, you ought to think about that. When you decide you don't want to go to church, when you decide things are so bad, I just need to stay home and maybe the Lord will come by the house. No, baby, you need to get to the church.
Yes,
because
yes.
Things happen in church that can't happen at home.
Yes.
Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
This lady could have been bitter against God.
Uh-huh.
You know, some folk do that. Trouble come, they get mad at you, they get mad at God, they get mad at the church, they don't have nothing to do with nobody. In fact, you can tell when they come to church, you can tell they're mad. But they come in with a frown on their face. Everything going in the church is wrong. And they leave with a frown on their face. Somebody, ain't nothing them Negroes right up in there. You're right, none of us are right, but at least we're in the house. This woman went to church. She was concerned because she needed some help. And the help that she needed, she knew if she could get to church, that help would be there. And on this particular Sunday, hello y'all, on this particular Sabbath, Jesus was teaching in this church. And immediately when he saw her, his heart went out to her. He had compassion on her. And he always helps whenever God, we give him a chance, God will always help us out. Have I got a witness in here?
Yes.
Look what he did. He said to the woman, "Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity." Now that doesn't mean that he straightened her back. He did that a little later on. But that was not necessary. He did something better than straighten her back. He gave her an inner strength to live happily and gloriously in spite of her bent back. What he did was he changed her mental attitude that whether or not she had a bent back from then on, it just did not matter. My brothers and sisters, I stopped by long enough just to share with somebody that many of us have this woman's same story. It can be ours. We all face circumstances in life that make it hard for us. But in facing up to our circumstances, sometimes we can gain some power. All of us have a handicap in some way. But there is never a situation that God's power cannot make us able to overcome. When Jesus loosed this woman from her spirit of infirmity, she remained bowed together. Her physical condition did not change. But thanks be to God, her mental condition changed. The church has many problems. We've got families fussing and fighting with each other.
Yes.
That's a handicap.
Yes.
We've got attitudes and feelings we wear on our sleeves. That's a handicap.
Yes.
We're always looking for and finding the shortcomings of everybody else. That's a handicap. We have unforgiving spirits. We have envy and jealousy.
Yes.
We have an unholy attitude toward our brothers and sisters in Christ. You need to know that that's a handicap.
Yes.
And if that spirit of infirmity continues to fester in our life, we're going to miss out on many blessings that God has got in store for us. I came to remind somebody that Jesus came and gave his life, died, rose from the dead, so that you don't have to be handicapped in your mind. Yeah, your heart's not right, but your mind ought to be straight. Yeah, you got pain in your body, but your mind ought to be straight. Yes, your family is acting crazy, but your mind ought to be straight. Because if your mind is straight, no matter what's going on in your life, you can lift your head toward heaven and say, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help do I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, oh, whither shall I go? The text reminds us that Jesus said to the woman, woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity. Yes. And immediately the woman began to praise God. Her back was bent, but she was praising God. Her trouble was still there, but she was praising God. What are you saying, preacher? All hell breaking loose in your house. You ought to still praise God. Your family's acting crazy. You ought to still praise God. You lose your job. You ought to still praise God. Because God has a way that's mighty sweet. Have I got a witness in here? He can do what no other power can do. The text says that while she was praising God for her spirit of infirmity being removed, that Jesus straightened her back. What are you saying, preacher? Not only will he deal with you in the midst of your circumstances, but he will bring you out. And when